Ladies and gentlemen, give a big round of applause to Miss Alexandra Karova.
All right. Let's give it up for the comics going on. Amazing, amazing, good stuff. I was coming over here and I heard the song, "Every Little Thing She Does Is Magic." And I thought, you know, if I were a stripper, that's the song I'd come out and dance to. You know what I mean? Because it's like, every little thing she does is magic. Everything she do just turn me on. Even though my life with her was tragic. Now I know my love for her goes on. Okay, anyway. Yeah, so I don't know if you guys ever think about what songs you'd want to strip to, but then I thought, you know, another one is lesser known, but in excess, one of their lesser known hits called "Suicidal Blonde." Not a very happy tune, but if I were stripping, it might be appropriate. It's like, I used to be a feminist. I used to have self-esteem. Where's the meth so I can numb out myself from what I'm doing? Pussy, pussy. Okay, anyway, here we go. Then it would be "This Is the End." I know these are sort of drop tunes to strip to, but "This Is the End" by Jim Morrison. This is the end, beautiful friend, the end. At least I'd be beautiful in there, you know. But it would be the end for me, because, you know, I'd have to go kill myself right afterwards. Because I just stripped. Anyway. The only thing that'll hold me back from being a stripper is that I don't do drugs. But when I was younger, I was sort of obsessed with it because I thought, oh my God, I could burn so many calories at work. You know, like you could work, it would just be a workout, and then you'd come back and hope you never run into them in real life, and you'd be in amazing shape. But whatever, just didn't work out because honestly, like, I had a friend who was a stripper, and I went to support her shows as an artist because she came to my comedy gigs. So we were like, you know, being supportive of one another. And I have to say, you guys, it is very tough to do a dance, be interesting, without wearing a bra. It's like, oh my God, you know, it's like it would hurt me. Anyway, and the other thing is what I noticed was, okay, you guys think comics have it rough. Strippers, okay? They have stripper open mics. It's called amateur night, right? They don't even get paid, these girls. Yeah, I know. They're showing it all. They're not even getting a drink. They're just working out, okay? And hoping to get a gig somewhere. And so I went to go watch her at this amateur night contest thing, because, you know, she was trying to get better gigs on other nights of the week where you can actually get paid and stuff. And she comes out, and the big song at the time was, "Everybody dance now!" Okay, anyway. So, she was amazing, you know, and gorgeous, right? And there's this girl who came out, and she looked like she just came from work as a secretary. And she was wearing a navy suit, like jacket and skirt. And she was wearing heels, not stripper heels, but like medium heels, like beige heels, okay? Yeah, she was not fancy schmancy at all. Just came from work, and she's there stripping. Okay, not to put her down, but you could tell she was an amateur. She was like, first time, whatever. but she was sweet, right? Like a new comic, whatever. So anyway, she's just doing this, and then like some music went, and she just kicked off her shoe, one shoe, because she's not a whore. And then she's moving around on one foot, sort of lopsided, trying to do a dance. Doesn't really work out. Okay, anyway. And then this third girl comes out. Now there were many more, but these are just the highlights. Third girl comes out in a white lacy dress with a white parasol. Yeah, you could tell she was from the Midwest, right? Not from LA. And she's like spinning it, and there was a very slow song, and she was just moving around a lot, and not really taking her clothes off that much. Yeah, yeah. Like I said, Midwest, not LA, right? And she was doing ballet moves and this and that. And, you know, maybe clothes came off, but I didn't even notice because she just seemed so classy. It just seemed like, I don't know, whatever. And guess who won the competition?
Business suit.
Okay.
Parasol.
It went to the parasol.
Oh.
Yeah, it did. Because what I realized was that the guys there, they didn't want... They didn't want somebody cool and hip and modern and really great with the dance moves, no. They wanted the illusion that the stripper was a virgin and would fall in love with them. They'd be the first guy. Because the guys that are there, folks, they're not in good relationships. They're looking for love. They're not smart enough to realize they're not going to find it here. Because these girls, even though maybe they do have a good chance because these girls are doing it for free right now, but ultimately, they're doing it for money. And if you don't buy them a new refrigerator, because that's what my girlfriend ended up doing. She kind of bought her a new refrigerator. They're not going to sleep with you. Thank you, from the married woman. From the married woman. All right, very good. Thank you. That's my target audience. It's the married people. And that's why all these single comedians didn't get it. I kill with those people in healthy relationships. All right. Yeah, because I've been saying positive affirmations like, Lord, you know, change me. Let me know I'm lovable and receive good love in my life. And so, you know, affirmations are powerful, and I'm pretty sure I'm going to meet someone soon. Thanks for laughing. I'll just tell you how my life's going, and, you know, hanging out with guys at college. I'm going back to college, and I'm working in the script library, and there was a guy that was picking up on me a week ago, and this week, something happened, which has never happened to me before, but I guess, you know, it happens when you get a little older, whatever. I was working on my computer, everyone was quiet in the script library, and I farted uncontrollably where I could not stop.
Oh, no, no.
Yeah. And it was so embarrassing. I said, sorry, guys. And it was so embarrassing that none of the guys responded or acknowledged it. Yeah. I love what Rose Hines said about goth guys being gay and being a screenwriting or horror script screenwriters. Because literally there's, and I also love about the gay baby that Alan Moore mentioned, the guys that don't know they're gay yet, which I've dated. And, you know, there's little tells, like when they suck dick. Anyway, okay. Take out the butt. I don't know, I'm just saying, maybe you're gay. Anyway, but that was so brilliant what she said, because there's a guy in the script library who writes horror films, totally is gay and doesn't know it yet, and I think, Alan, you should tell him. I think you should come with me to school and just break the news to him. the other thing is, I was, for this week, since it was Halloween week, one teacher gave us extra credit if we brought in photos of ourselves in costume. And so I brought in a picture of myself as a nun, picture of myself, well, it was a very slutty nun, though. She had the makeup on, you know, anyway, I looked good. And a picture of myself with Jesus, you know, the guy who walks around the comedy store dressed as Jesus? Yeah, okay, so that was good. And you had to have good costumes to get the point. Then a picture of myself as Liz Taylor, which I did up. I don't know if you guys have seen those photos on Facebook, but it was after she died. It was my homage to her. And this guy, this teacher, who, you know, I was almost afraid of showing anything too attractive around him, because at school, you guys, I don't look like this. I don't get all dressed up and fabulous with jewels and everything and whatever. I'm a plain Jane, I gotta tell you. And so my teacher, even when you're a plain Jane, though, you have guys who are inappropriately sexually harassing you, because I can't stop the hotness, first of all. And second of all, because I think they pick on you because they think they have a chance in hell with you. Like, he doesn't know how good-looking I really am. You know, I'm way out of your league. Anyway, and so he's always, you know, doing inappropriate stuff, like I'm sitting right there and he'll lift his leg up so his crotch is going right in my face and go, "So next week we're going to do reports about broadcasting." And I literally have to, like, turn my head away and look at the students like this. And I asked them, I said, "Do you guys notice that he, like, is always sticking his crotch near my face?" And the guys were like, "Yeah, I was wondering if that bugged you or not." So I was sort of afraid to show him the pretty pictures of me, because I didn't want him to, you know, have more reason to jack off to me and I'm not in the classroom. And he literally says, after my glamorous pictures are up there, he's like, "Well, obviously these were taken years ago."
Oh!
And I was like, "No! I'm a genius makeup artist, and I'm great with lighting and makeup and hair and wigs and..." And then I thought, no, just let him believe. But still, it was very, very rude. And I just have to say, you guys, being a comedian, I love it. Because it's like in the movie Kill Bill. Uma Thurman playing Beatrix Kiddo, where she's told by Bill, other people are Clark Kent, and they dress up and they become Superman. But you, Beatrix Kiddo, you are Superman. And you dress down to act like you're Clark Kent. And that's what I feel like it is for us. I'm really Beatrix Kiddo / Superman. But I tone it down so I can fit in with the rest of the world. Take notes and come up with genius comedy material like the rest of you. It'll be all those secrets. Anyway, I love this show. God bless you. Good night, thank you.